Hello people, Molecular Biology and Biotechnology welcomes you to 2021, and we begin off with a sneak preview of mitochondrial DNA, also called mtDNA, that is found in the mitochondria, an organelle within the cell, and it is different from nuclear DNA, which is our main nucleic acid, which is contained in the nucleus. Mitochondrial DNA is usually inherited from mother to child 100%, and the nuclear DNA is inherited from both parents, 50% coming from the mother and 50% coming from the father. It is a small double-stranded DNA that is over 1,000 copies per cell, and usually 16, 5, 69 base pairs with 44% GC content, that is guanosine and cytosine, and usually has a light strand and a heavy strand. This is also called H strand, and this is also called L strand. And it has 37 genes that are essential for normal mitochondrial function, particularly in the production of ATP. It is haploid in nature because the genes that are in mitochondrial DNA are single. And then we also have what we call a D loop here at the structure of the mitochondrial DNA. And now these are the genes of this mitochondrial DNA. So why is mitochondrial DNA important? It is particularly important in forensics when we want to identify maternal lineage or linkage of individuals, either because there is a forensic or crime issue, or maybe someone wants to understand their maternal lineage. We also have mitochondrial DNA being used in phylogenetic systems, where we have building of family trees, who is related to who. And it can give us now the relationships or the relatedness using maternal identification. We also have population and conservation genetics, because mitochondrial DNA has very few, you know, mutations. Like within 8,000 years, we'll just have one mutation. So that way we are able to understand organisms and be able to, you know, map the genetics of organisms and populations. Now, in forensics particularly, like I have mentioned, it is used when biological evidence has been degraded, like in charred remains, in fire accidents. We also have when we have now very small quantity of evidence. And usually, such cases will use things like hair, bones, and teeth. For example, if you have missing persons cases, you can use skeletal remains, because this means that probably somebody has gotten lost, they have died, decomposed, and all what can be found is skeletal remains. And in this case, most of the biological evidence like blood, tissue has been degraded. So this is a good time to use mitochondrial DNA to identify those persons. And then when you want to establish individuals as suspects in some crime, and probably just hair was left at the crime scene. You see, this is very little evidence, but very useful if you go the mitochondrial DNA way, and many other forms. And now we also have this mitochondrial DNA being the science behind family ancestry. And there's a theory that has been made by Kahn, Stone, King, and Wilson in 1987, although it has been contested over time, and I will give you an assignment to go find out if this theory still stands or it's a myth, or what is the position currently. So these three guys suggested that you might have a common female ancestor. And if you look at this word female, it then means that we are using mitochondrial DNA, because this one is only traced through the maternal lineage. And they called this ancestor Mitochondrial Eve. and she's believed to have lived 2,000 years ago. And this theory states that all people are related to this mitochondrial Eve regardless of their perceived race. And she belonged to a macrohaplogroup. We'll be looking at what is a haplogroup, L. And it is believed that Asians, Europeans, and Africans all have this as the root haplogroup. Now, in mitochondrial sequences, we usually don't use the word alleles, we use haplotypes. And a haplotype is a group of genes that are coming from a single parent. And we say that in mitochondrial DNA, we have haploid, only one set of chromosomes. And then genotype means the genetic makeup. So this haplotype is made up from haploid, then genotype. And now, once you name the sequences as haplotypes, you form what we call a haplogroup. And this is now a genetic population that is defined by differences in mitochondrial DNA. So this is now where the theory came from, because it means that now a certain group of people share a common ancestor on the matriline, and now we give them certain alphabets and then refine them with additional numbers or letter combinations. Like for mitochondrial Eve, the haplogroup L, you can see that now that is where now we have LO, L1, L5, and so on and so forth, as indicated on this diagram. And that means from this theory that then we began there, then people migrated, then different races were formed, and so on and so forth. Yes, thank you so much, guys. That is a sneak preview. Remember to read widely so that you can build up on concepts more and more.